Welcome to our GoDaddy website builder review. Once again, GoDaddy has introduced a brand new version called GoCentral now. Their previous website builder was too basic and lacked some key features like a blog or password protection. Let's see if the new version is as lackluster as their previous, or if it has more to offer now. The first thing we like is that you can now test GoDaddy's website builder free for 1 month. If you like it, you can then choose from one of the plans. If you're planning to open an online store, keep in mind that only the highest tier will allow you to do so. Unfortunately, a domain is not included, but can be purchased separately through their interface. If you already have one, you can also transfer or redirect it. After the sign-up, we see a preview of the chosen design. There aren't many, but they're all responsive. This means they're optimized for mobile phones, as you can see here. Let's jump into the editor and play around with some of the features. If you want to change the theme, click here. There are 6 styles available, and you can choose a main color that will be used for the headlines, links, and buttons. You can also pick one particular font. However, it's not possible to add any other font type. Every single page contains a header and a footer. You see all included sections here. When we click on one, we see some options. Here we can decide if we want to have a call to action button, for example. Also, feel free to change the header title. But what if you want another layout style? Click on the Layout button and click through the alternatives. You won't lose any content by switching it. We find it annoying that there's no way to move around the title or even change the font size. This is the same problem with any other element. Let me show you what I mean. To add a new element, you click on this bubble and pick Video in this case. There's only one specific way to add one. It's not possible to make it smaller or place text next to it. We really think this is too limited. If you want to add a new page, you click on the navigation menu. Give it a name and decide if you want to either show or hide it in the navigation. You could do this to link a page with some information that you don't want to show in the navigation. However, just like in the previous Site Builder version, there is no password protection for your pages available. Under Manage Pages, we can change the order. Unfortunately, there are no sublevels available. This will be a major issue if you want to create a large website. More general settings can be found here. Click on Search Engine Optimization and fill in your title and description. This is the information that Google will show in their search results. The website builder also comes with an online store. It allows you to sell physical goods or services. However, you can't sell digital items like MP3s or videos. Here's an example of a product page. It also doesn't allow personal logins, ratings, or recommended products. It's a very basic solution. When we started to test the new editor, we were hoping for a product that finally improved upon the issues from the previous version. We were happy to see that all designs are responsive now and that it features SSL encryption, which is good for security and also recommended by Google. However, there are too many features still missing. Password protection, a blog, an app store to add new features, and so much more. As you saw earlier, customizing the layout is very limited. The online store is generally not bad, but it's far too expensive compared to professional solutions like Shopify or Weebly. You will find further information in our detailed review. There, you can also find some alternatives that you can test for free. We hope you liked this short summary, and if you have any questions, just leave us a comment. Thank you.